Yeah, thank you. So, hello everyone. Today I would like to share my experience how I pass online course about C++ 17. Talk about course. This course is include a lot of lessons, quiz, code exams that you can run online. This course covers new features of C++ 70, such as SAD option, SAD any string view, file system, new search string algorithms, parallel SAD algorithm, and other features. As you know, some features are from Boost library, but not all people have experience with Boost, so I think it will be useful for them if you use Boost instead C++ 17. Few words about author. He is Belomir Filipper. I hope I pronounced correctly. You can know he as author of book C++ 70 in details. Yes, this course is similar to this book, but as for me, course is more structured and have quiz. Also, you have run exam online. And also, this author has good blog. So let's start about course. One moment, I will open the browse. So this course have several chapters, and you can see a lot of them, and each chapters has several lessons, and some lesson have several topic. One moment, for example. Yeah, we have chapters, we have lesson, and some lesson have several topics. Some topics has reference to extra information. For example, yeah, extra information, and you can see why it was removed. For example, it's about SAD iteration or maybe some details about other features. Also, each topic has good instruction to new features, explain how to use, compare with previous standard, have good example. End of chapters has compile support when you can check your compile feature. For example, yeah, compile supports, and the most popular compilers: GDC, Clang, Microsoft Visual Studio. So next, also you can ran exam online, for example. Yeah, for example, we have some example in, and you can run online without run EDA and your compile, and also you can change this example of modifying. So next, yeah, and each example have quiz. For example, yeah, where you can choose some option and check your answer. And it will help to check how you understand your I have to understand this material of lessons. Also, you can see your progress, for example, for each chapters. For example, some lessons are marked as complete with green color, and other lessons make us not completed with blue color, with white color. And when you finish lesson, you click next and mark is complete. Let's talk about pros and cons of this course. So first, it's a good structure, very useful example, and show how you can refactor your old code. Of course, it's online running. You can run example with that TE quiz. As for me, if you know that you will have quiz after chapters, you will learn material better. Also, there are some cons. There are not any certificates. It is not a big problem, but I think it will be better to have some certificate after finish this course. And you can mark lesson or course as complete without reading. As for me, it's so difficult to check person who passed the course. What I mean? For example, you can just mark all lessons as complete, and also you can click mark course as completed. Well, as for me, I think it's not a good idea. About price, if you connect from Ukrainian, you have 14% discount, and you can buy subscription for all course for all course and pay each month, or you can buy only this course. As for me, I use it second way. About alternatives, of course you can buy a book or use other sites like CPP reference, Learn CPP, CPP quiz, and other like Google Stack Overflow and other information about C++ 70 is free, and you can find all information about standard, but sometimes they are not very good structured, not enough example, and you cannot check how you good understood information without quiz. So it's up to you how to learn C++ 17. Let's summarize. This course is very convenient and with good example. My recommendation, if you use C++ 70 very often in your project and you have new team member that don't know C++ 70 or don't have experience with boot, so I think it will be very useful. Also, I think it will be good who wants switch to C++ 70 quickly. So, do you have any questions?
Yes, I have a question. Thank you for the presentation. From your point of view, does it make sense to go through both book and this course?
I think it's up to you how more convenient for you. If you want to have books, it's like file. You can download and read, but if it's more convenient to have online access and check example online without run EDA, so it will be convenient to have online course. And also, it depends on price.
Yeah, but does it make sense, for example, if I read this book entirely, does it make sense to go through the course or vice versa? If I went through the course, to read this book additionally?
No, I think book is pretty enough. But they are not quiz.
Okay.
No,
okay.
As for me, I have read these books and passed this exam, and book is pretty good.
Okay, thanks.
I also have a comment from myself. If you have GitHub student pack, then I believe you have 6 months subscription on Educative for free.
Oh, I don't know about it. Thank you for your comments. So I think that's all.